some teachers. They are really very good for the new teacher perhaps, but they are a menace for the teacher who wants to do something differently. But the reason we did that was because we had a high teacher turnover, and coordinated lesson plans are the first step to natural collegiality. I mean, when you really actually want to get together, do something together, the first step is probably to put you into the experience. So that is what the idea was. So we are looking at an integrated curriculum perhaps. Maybe that is an answer, when teachers will have more time to spend more time on their lesson plans, because time is a big issue. They'd probably have more time to think about their teaching. We're also thinking of building learning communities. That could be a very good way of people getting together and actually talking about their teaching, learning from each other. Now, this used to happen in some of our schools even 15 years ago, when teachers used to get together and say, look, I'm doing this topic in my science class. Are you doing this in maths? Let's get together and do a lesson. But somehow, with the onset of the standardized curriculum, a lot of this kind of creativity has, you know, we've had to compromise that. So perhaps developing the sense to be in one kind of a community and to learn from each other, do things together. And as Marie-Louise said, there's no leader there, there's no follower. We are all together as learners, and we continue to teach each other and learn from each other. So even the teacher or the head of school could just be part of a group that could just be exploring a new pedagogy in teaching fractions in mathematics. Have I got that right? Yes. So that's the kind of thing we think about doing. Okay. One of the issues is teacher-centered, exam-oriented secondary school. The reason is there's pressure from the community, from parents, from the environment, from the universities in Pakistan and abroad to produce good academic grades. It's as simple as that. Well, as somebody said at a panel discussion this morning, it is possible to create opportunities within the schedule of secondary teachers for experiential learning. I think a lot of our O and A level and secondary teachers would be able to tell you how they've actually used this in their classes. I remember I was observing a physics class at the O level one day, and the physics teacher said to me, Mrs. Huck, you don't know physics at O level. How are you going to observe my class? I said, just let me sit through it. I'll probably pick up something at the end. And at the end of it, I said to him, I said, you were teaching them the tester, you know, the electricity gadget that's a tester. I said, you made three diagrams on the blackboard and you labeled it. Why couldn't you bring some testers to class? They could probably have opened them up and looked at them and sort of be able to understand how it works and what's inside. So I'm sure there are lots of teachers who could use experiential learning, active learning in their secondary school classes. Yes, the reason why there's pressure to produce results, limited professions and university places, highly competitive exam environment, existing practices have proven to be effective. These results, this method of teaching has got our students places in the best universities in the world. They have given them, you know, career options. Our students are in all kinds of careers. They're in the media, they're in engineering, they're doctors, they're everywhere. So what's wrong with this system, the teachers ask us? So perhaps there's something to think about there. We could educate parents on the importance of their child's ability. Probably educate them that children sometimes don't perform as you as adults want them to perform. They surprise us. And that's something that we need to learn as parents. And then we need to value the risk-taker teacher again. If there's a teacher who's willing to use unconventional methods in teaching our students and perhaps for a year or so not get the results that we want them to get, it's not the end of the world. Maybe we could give that teacher a little bit more time. And I think what we could do is involve teachers and students in the design process, the design of the curriculum, the secondary curriculum, if we could help take the students' views and have teachers use them to create more valuable and fun lessons. There can be fun in the secondary school, I promise you, there can be. From early years, we've got insufficient resources for equipping, organizing, and managing play. The reason is our expansion. Probably we need to look at providing more resources. And English language proficiency is becoming a problem. We are an English medium school, so we are facing this problem, and we are trying to address it in the best and supportive manner. Teacher education. The issues are formal professional development events with limited follow-up, one size fits all, limited support by school administration, focus on teacher education rather than on the job competency building, limited subject-specific training. What next? Combination of the formal and informal, more school-based professional development. And I'll talk about supporting teachers on the job competency development, and again on the development of the school as a learning community. This also means that teachers exchange with our international teachers, build on best practices. We use social networks like Ning and other networks. I'm sure there are many others for teachers to interact with each other. And we include the senior management of schools in the school-based development, professional development programs. We plan and conduct subject-specific training in the latest pedagogies. The core messages of the training are not disseminated to all stakeholders. The concentration is on teachers and heads. We have more communication with each stakeholder. The core messages to be documented and reflected in the system's policies, insufficient human resource, long distance learning is maybe an answer, localized conferences for teachers and school management could be a way of capacity building, insufficient support and training for the school management and leadership, exponential expansion, leadership training and support programs may be an answer. The job has become more administrative than school leadership. And we need to include more online support. A problem has been that there's been a belief that good teachers make good heads. We still agree with that. However, that teacher, once she comes into the position of a head, needs to be trained and supported in management skills. Risk-taking. I remember Brian Caldwell, one of his books called The Creating an Excellent School, mentions the qualities of outstanding school leaders. And one of the qualities that he mentions is outstanding risk-taking. Creative problem-solving. Those are the skills that we should and we want to develop in our heads. And the thought that leaders should continue to be learners and improve on the skills that need to be developed. We also, as management, need to understand that exam results are not the only measure of success. There is more to school than just exam results. And I'm sure the primary and the early years teachers will bear me out. Isn't that so? Yes. Parents don't look for exam results when they come to put their child in the early years. What they want is somebody to care for their child and to teach them how to cope with life. There is also a limited know-how of self-review, school evaluation and school improvement, and how the two are related. And there are insufficient human resources to train. So you must have heard, we've developed the school improvement framework, encourage self-improving schools. I know it still sounds too ambitious as I read it, but anyway, we'll still trying, we'll get there. And before I leave, I'd want us all to take an oath. And it's a simple oath. Keep loving the children you teach. Keep learning. And remember that we learn from our students more than they learn from them. I couldn't operate this. I'm sure all my students are able to do much more than this. And also, finally, be passionate. Follow your heart, but don't follow it without your head. Thank you very much.